Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video I am going to explain the construction contract part 3. In this part 3 I will explain the of the contract. This is just this we can say there the general condition of contract and the special condition of contract. So this is very important part for the construction contract. So watch this carefully and I request you to watch this till end. And if you like this video, so please click on the like button. First I am going to explain the general condition contract conditions that set the minimum performance requirements for the contractor and are common to all types of contracts. These conditions are also include the right architect as well as contractor involved. GCCs are integral part of the contract. So this is the definition of the contract. So let's start the important clauses of the general condition. In this definition clause we define what is engineer, architect, contractor, client, owner, virtual completion, working time and other terms used in the contract. We explain here. The second one is the scope of work. In this scope of work, date of commencement. Date of commencement means at what date the work will start by the contractor. So we can say that that is the starting date of the project. Nature of contract. Nature of contract, lump sum contract or cost plus contract. So this is the nature of contract. Next one is all inclusive rates. We define whether the rates are inclusive of taxes or exclusive of taxes. Is exclusive or inclusive we define in this clause. Next one is insurance. In this insurance part, like the all risk policies, so the contractor will provide the all risk policies and any other insurance required. So who will be responsible, whether the contractor will do it or the client will do? So in this insurance part we define all these things. It's very important clause actually. Labor regulations. In this labor regulation, contractor will be responsible for all labor laws such as payment, wages, etc. So I explain here definition, scope of work, date of commencement, nature of contract, all inclusive rates, insurance and labor regulations. Few of them are still remaining, so let's go to the next slide. ESI and EPF. ES, contribution benefit, like employees state insurance, this is ESI, and employees provident fund, EPF. So the contractor will also responsible for this thing. So next one is mode of measurement, and any other method will be followed. So in this mode of measurement the description is given. Next one is payment, how the payment will be given. I mean, there is any advance payment, and after submitting the running account bill, how the payment will be released. There is any ad hoc payment will be released. So all these payments related things is mentioned in this payment clause. Next one is extra item, substituted item. How the extra item is defined. I mean, whether the profit is 15% cost plus materials plus labor, whatever is in it is defined how extra item or substitute item will be derived. So this is also an important clause. Next one is time for completion. So as you know that the what is the time of completion, we mention it whether it is a 1 year project or 2 year. So by on what date this project will be completed. Next one is virtual completion of work. Virtual completion of work is actually completion with snags. We give a late in the construction field, the safety clause. It is all safety codes to be followed, and if there is any penalty if the contractor is not following the safety codes, so we mention. So I explain ESI and EPF, mode of measurement, payments, extra items, substituted items, time for completion, virtual completion of work and safety. Now there is a few clauses also left in the general condition of contract. So let's go to the next slide. In this next slide, this is the dispute settlement and arbitration. So a form of alternative dispute resolution is a way to resolve dispute outside the court. So this is the Arbitration is the a system by which you can get a settlement outside of the important liquidated damages. If project is delayed, so what the penalty will be imposed on the contractor? So this is called the liquidated damages. Generally, the liquid more than the fact. And next one is extension of time. So in what circumstances given to the contractor? Guarantees of the work. Whatever the work executed by the contractor, so the contractor will give the guarantee for that. Defect liability period. In this defect liability period is withheld with the client, and after defect liability period, that security or retention money is released. This is a force majeure. Force majeure actually condition in which, in what circumstances the delay is not considered. If any delays is happened, but there is some circumstances, if there between two countries or any earthquake happen, so in these conditions, in the delay is not considered. Last, termination. Termination is the conditions to terminate the contract by the client or by the contract. So I explain here dispute settlement and arbitration, liquidated damages, extension of time, guarantees, defect liability period, force majeure, and termination. So these all were the general condition of contract. Now let's move to a special condition of contract. Special condition of contract. What is a special condition of contract? The condition which do not fall under general conditions and is specific for the particular project. So this is called a special condition. So special condition of contract. First is performance bond. A bond issued by a bank guaranteeing the fulfillment of a particular contract. This is a performance. Next one is earnest money. An earnest money is a specific form of security deposit made in some major transactions such as real estate dealings or required by some official procurement process. It is serious and willing to demonstrate an earnest of good faith, wanting to complete the transaction. So whether he is serious or not, for that they have to deposit some money. Next one is mobilization advance. Advance given to the contractor on the value of the project. Next one is water and electricity. Whether client will provide free of cost or contractor will arrange. So this is a water and electricity. Next one is escalation free contract. Supply of material by client. So what are the materials supplied by the client? So we mention here, and what will be the wastage consideration. This is mentioned in this clause. And last but not the least, retention money and security deposit, which I explained earlier at the time of defect liability period. So this retention amount is withheld with the client for the rectification of the work. If contractor not rectify the work during the defect liability period, so by this security amount, that